Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. So,
this is like a really weird angle.
Today we've got another Chinese mukbang, and I haven't done one of these in so long. I feel like I start every mukbang saying, OMG, I haven't done a mukbang in forever. I just want to say that there now I just came out, like outside with my camera, and I had like everything in my hands. And I just dropped my camera on the ground. So this could actually have a giant crack in the lens, and I literally wouldn't even know. Because I literally just dropped it and I'm just trying my best not to look at it because I would actually die. My camera was like fucking £500. Anyway, because I'm outside, it's going to get colder quicker. But I thought, you know, the vibe, the aesthetic of outside is just so much more satisfying to me. So we're sitting outside today and I just really like being outside. Why am I moving my fingers? Anyway, first thing we've got sauce noodles with black bean sauce on it. Literally looks so good. I just love my noodles with black bean. Like, it's nice with curry, but I do prefer it with black bean. And then we've also got salt and chilli chips. We've got rice, curry, normal chips, spring rolls. Just the usual, you know. It is kind of low-key cold. And, like, I literally just caught it, but I did have to, like, set up my camera and stuff. But she's a bit cool, guys. We're not going to lie. I honestly couldn't decide whether I wanted to get this or a pizza. I actually had it in my head today that I was gonna go to Solo and Mara Felt because those people asked me to do a Solo pizza thing. I don't think I'm in the center, which is like really annoying. There we go. So yeah, loads of people asked me to do like a Solo pizza mukbang, and then I actually went on. I think I've been there like twice and it's been unreal. Like, I really, really like it. I was gonna go up today and also get a pizza. But I went for lunch today and I got flies. Yeah, so I went for lunch and got, oh my god, these are good. Really money spring rolls. They're literally unreal. So yeah, I went to the lab earlier and got a toast day. I normally get like breakfast, but I was like, fuck it, I'll get toast. It was like 2 o'clock and I had night, yeah. Because I was working in the morning. And then also that child in the park needs to stop screaming, but whatever. So basically, if I would ever finish this story, I went and I got a toastie and it was like quite greasy because it was like cheese, but it was like nice greasy, like it wasn't like rotten or anything. It was really nice. But then I thought, like, if I get a cheesy pizza, I'm gonna like have the worst diarrhea. Just being honest, girl's aggressively lactose intolerant, to be completely honest with you. But I just have to ignore it and take the hit because ice cream, pizza, it's just a bit of me, and cheese also a bit of me. So if I have one thing, it's not too bad, but I couldn't be having both of those things, like, knowing it was going to be, like, shitty, do you know what I mean? So I just thought, fuck it, a Chinese, because I haven't done a Chinese bit right, and oh my god, it feels like forever. It really does. So that's just, I also forgot to say that it's from Castle Dawson Chinese, but guys, you really better know it's from Castle Dawson Chinese. I know we did Blahe one time, but Castle Dawson just is the best. And like, let's not have an argument about it. Let's not even debate it. Like, I don't care if you think it's somewhere else. It's not. Mummy's, bless mummy, she's in there eating her wee Chinese by herself. My mummy's obsessed with Chinese. I think it's why that we all like Chinese so much, because whenever we were children, we used to go to my nanny's house every Saturday, and she lives in Belfast. We would go and then we would stop in Tim on the way home. Tim Chinese, which is also, guys, I really like Tim Chinese as well. Tim and Castle Dawson's my two faves, but I just don't ever be in Tim, so I don't really get it. Anyway, we used to go to Tim every Saturday and we would get a chicken curry, a rice and a chip, and me, Aoife, mummy and Oni would all split a chicken curry, a rice and a chip, like the four of us. Like, I don't know how that filled anyone. But I did that for approximately 10 years of my life every Saturday, so was it any wonder I'm obsessed with, like, curry? Funny story, I also was out last night. Was it last night? Yeah. But I didn't really drink much because obviously I was working today, so I was out last night and was kind of hungry in the bar, so I went and got Chinese. judge me less. That was disgusting. Anyway, I went got a Chinese, but I was sharing it with Roshan, and I got, please don't click on the videos, I got a gravy chippy and onion. Like, I know, gravy out of Chinese, like, who the fuck do I think I am? That is so embarrassing. But Roshan doesn't like Korean, and I just wanted like a half, I didn't want a full thing, so I had to get a gravy chippy and onion, and I was like, I'm gonna swear, like, I actually wish I took a photo of it because it literally looked like black tar. Like, it was nice, but it's just the look of the gravy and the Chinese. Like, why does it look like black tar? Do you know what I mean? I don't really know if you can tell, but it's, like, really dull outside. It was, like, such a nice day earlier. Like, it was, like, 23 degrees. It was, like, sunny. And then it just, like, started getting pure cloudy. And now I think it gives to rain. Like, it's still quite warm. It's just a bit breezy. And like the sun is just absolutely nowhere to be seen, which is like, you know, if this is our summer, if this is our like good weather, you remember like last year in the first lockdown, the weather was literally unbelievable for like 3 weeks. If this is our good weather, I swear, I'm done, because it's actually like, it's good and it's warm, but it's like always windy and it's always cloudy, so it's like you can't even really sunbathe or like be outside for too long, because then you get really cold. So Aoife ditched me today and she went to go for dinner, and she went to actually go for a Chinese in Derry, Mandarin Palace or something. And I'm literally not joking, I bet you she'll come home and say that Castle Dawson's nicer. Like, there's like so many like nice like places to do Chinese, but you just can't beat like, oh my god, did I say can I? You just can't beat like your local Chinese. Oh my god, I'm pure like stuffed, like my nose, not my stomach, but also here's something I would like some feedback on. So remember I had coronavirus at the end of 2020, so it was like December into like New Year. Well, I'm pretty sure I spoke about what my symptoms were, and they were like majorly. Oh my god, my brain is just not working. I don't know if you can tell, I'm literally so tired. I had like, I was just like thought it like all weekend, and like, you know when you just like get like no sleep, like you don't get good sleep. Like, I don't run well without enough sleep, enough water, and like decent food. Like, I would be grumpy, I would be down bad. I feel like so down bad right now, like my voice. Anyway, we're off track. What was my story? What was the story? If that doesn't show you how bad my brain's working, then I don't know. What was I talking about? Literally, what was I talking about before I went off? Whatever, stage right there. Oh my god, I actually can't remember. That's so bad, James. Oh, I remember. Yes, right, so if anyone has had coronavirus. No, so I had coronavirus in December, and the majority of my symptoms was a sinus infection, and like I thought, like basically the whole time I had coronavirus up until I lost my taste and smell, I just had a sinus infection because it was just like all here, like I had no chest, like no throat or anything. Anyway, so as you can probably imagine, like during that time, I literally could not breathe out of my nose, like it was like clogged to like new extremes, and like it was just so much. I think I remember saying it felt like someone was just sitting on my nose all the time, like it was just, there was so much pressure. Fun fact, it is now 6 months later and I still can't breathe out of my nose. Like I can, but like not 100%. So like when I notice it the most is when I'm sleeping, and like if I lie on this side, I'll wake up and this nostril will be stuffed because obviously everything like ran to that side. And then when I get up, I'll feel it like for maybe an hour, I'll feel it like popping and stuff. So it's obviously like moving like into the middle again. And then like I noticed it because I went to run the other day for like the first time in ages, because I've been running with Kimogi, but like you're not like consciously running, like you're just running and you're not like considering your breathing or anything. Can you hear stuff in my nose? Anyway, I realise like I can't fully breathe out of both nostrils at all times. Like I have one stuffed and the other one's not stuffed, and it just like depends what way I'm lying or I don't know what way my hair's moved more that side, which one's stuffed. So it's kind of annoying because then, like, when I'm running and, like, walking and stuff, like, I have to, like, breathe through my mouth, which, like, I'm sure everyone does, but I just feel like I dry out so much quicker and it's harder to get a breath, obviously. Anyway, when I googled it, it said I had just, like, a chronic sinus infection or a sinusitis or whatever, because, like, I still have a stuffed nose and it's literally been 6 months. Like, it hasn't been, like, 3 weeks. It's been literally 6 months. Has anyone else got these symptoms or had these symptoms and, like, found a way to get rid of them? Because I really need to breathe properly. Like, breathing, like, to me is, like, one of the most important things, like, getting your breathing right. And, like, it just messes everything else up in your body if your breathing's bad. Look, I'm fully aware of that. But I don't know how to get my breathing back because I obviously have some sort of, like, damage to my sinuses from it. And I think, this is disgusting what I'm doing, but whatever. I think, mommy's staring at me. Oh, to finish, clear plates. Anyway, I think that I spoke before about how my other, like, long-term coronavirus / was it even coronavirus or did I have sinusitis symptoms was that I was getting really bad sore heads. Now, touch wood, oh my god, there's no wood around me. Touch glass that my sore heads have stopped. They just stopped, and they honestly stopped after I finished uni, so I think they were more like stress headaches, which, I mean, that's fine. I didn't used to get sore heads, and I definitely didn't used to get any sort of, like, physical symptoms when I was stressed, so they've went away, but it's still the nose thing, and it just, I don't know, it's getting just really past the point of, like, oh my god, like, am I going to ever get rid of my blocked nose? Also, speaking of uni, it is currently Sunday, 13th of June, so I'm, like, expecting my classification results, like, literally any day now. Let's actually check. I've checked, like, 4 times a day, and, like, it's a Sunday, so, like, it's probably not going to be up on a Sunday, but, like, they don't, my course, like, I went to Jordanstown, so if you go to Queens, like, Jordanstown don't even tell you, like, a date that your results are going to be. You just have to keep checking, like, Blackboard. Yeah, no, nothing. So, you can all comment down below what you thought I got my degree. I don't actually care that much what I got my degree because I'm not even too sure if I want to get a job in it yet, but guys, we'll see what happens. Anyway, so I finished my food. My nose is so stuffed, I literally sound ridiculous. I literally can't breathe in my nose. That's why I sound like a pure nasally today. Like, I sound like really deep, very manly. We're finished, guys. That was actually gorge, and that was, like, the perfect amount of food for me. I see some people on Instagram and they really be having the small plates with, like, 3 grains of rice and 3 chips. And you do you, but, like, I just, it wouldn't fill a hole in my tooth. That was just, like, the perfect amount of food because I was scared of feeling sick. Like, eating too much. Thanks for coming along and having your dinner with me if you're eating, and if you're not eating and you're just watching, even more appreciation for the dedication to just sit and watch the videos when you're not even eating. I can't eat dinner by myself without watching a mukbang. Like, I literally have to, especially if I'm, like, leading. Oh my god, you know, I keep trying to, like talk, but I keep getting caught. My nose keeps getting caught. Yeah, if before my dinner, like, I always have to watch a mukbang to get me, like, in the mood for dinner. Like, do you know what I mean? And at the minute, I'm pure into, like, 10,000 calorie challenges. So should I do 10,000 calorie challenge? Like, I've wanted to do it for ages, but, like, when am I going to do it? Like, I have training, like, every day, or a match or something. Like, I can't be eating 10,000 calories and then trying to be going to training. Or, like, maybe I could, and then it would help burn it off. Like, I just can't tell how it's going to make me feel. Like, I've never counted calories because I just don't really want to get, like, a bad relationship with food, because it can get really toxic really quickly, and I don't want to live like that. If I had to estimate, I'd say I eat about, like, 2,500 calories a day. Like, I do eat, like, really, like, a lot, and especially in comparison to some other people that I see on social media. But then I think people sometimes lie, like, or maybe people don't lie and all I see is people that eat way less calories than me on my TikTok. But yeah, I reckon, like, I do eat, like, a significant amount of calories anyway, so I actually think I could do it, especially because I'm vegetarian. So, like, it doesn't take me very long to get hungry after I eat because, like, I don't eat meat. So, like, everything, like, digests, like, really quickly. Do you know what I mean? Like, it breaks down really quickly. Like, whereas, like, all, like, proteins and stuff keep you full for, like, really long. I have no idea. Anyway, I've been just talking shit at this point. I hope you all enjoyed. If you want to see more mukbangs, let me know. Sorry if the vibes are kind of down, guys. I'm ready to sleep. It's literally 7 o'clock and I actually low-key might go to bed because I'm just so tired and it's just very moody outside. We've got very moody scenes today. Hope you all enjoy. See you next time.